Hi, my name's John Edmonds, and I own this book, which I hope you can see, and it's not reflecting too much, is a book called Getting a Start, First Aids to Success. And it was written in 1915. And it has a section called Opportunity, which is as relevant today as it's ever been. Because don't forget that 90% of what we have in today's world wasn't even thought about in 1915. Here's what the book says about opportunity. Opportunity never carries a torch. It travels on byways and along side streets. It makes no noise. No herald sounds its approach. It passes along in the quiet of a starless night. It makes no effort to meet anyone. It never extends a welcome. It minds its own business. But it is ever ready to grasp the hand held out to it and to be a permanent guest in the house of progress. Opportunity is in the very air that we breathe. It's on the main street, it's on the side street, and it inhabits the alley. It may not be as cordial to one as another, and it may seem to ignore some districts and occupations, but it is there, everywhere, below the surface, if not above the ground. Opportunity cannot be seen unless you're looking for it. To many, it seems like a stranger, and thousands are looking for it and never find it. But you see, it's not the fault of opportunity. The seeker may be to blame. If opportunity does not appear to be where you are, don't change your environment, but hunt all the more diligently for it. If after persistent search you cannot locate it, then consider a change of base. But remember that where you are may be the best place in which for you to stay. And it's the best place for you anyway, until you see a light ahead. Don't plunge from the shadows of the present into the darkness of the future. Stay where you are, even though there seems to be not even reflected opportunity around you, until you're able to place your finger upon the opportunity of elsewhere. You know the outs of the place you occupy. Because you're there, you see all the disadvantages of your environment. Most likely, you will magnify your troubles and imagine much that isn't so. The unexplored, the place you have not seen, shines by the light of your imagination. The blurs of dissatisfaction may look like stars of hope, which lead out into the great unknown, the untried land of opportunity, expected, but may not be materialized. Discouragement and opportunity are in the same street. There never were two avenues with both sides alike. Good and bad travel on the same highway. Disaster and success are often mated. Opportunity is not always surrounded by opportunity, but may be hiding in the midst of disaster. Opportunity may be near at hand. It's just as likely to be close as be far off. It hasn't any special abiding place, and it inhabits the shop as well as the office. Go after it. Don't wait for it seldom arrives of its own volition. It will not come to meet you. You must meet it. Hunt for it, and you may not find it. But you will not find it if you don't hunt for it. That was word for word from this book. So I just hope that you'll maybe get a message from that. You know, the book is quite rare. In fact, this is a first edition copy, and I haven't managed to find another edition anywhere on the planet. And if you'd like to download this little video to be able to use it somewhere, then please do. Or if you can't, then contact me and I'll organise some way of you being able to access this video to be able to use it for your people. Thank you for listening. Goodbye.